guys, this is Dan from Generation Productions back again for another bit of a quick chit chat with a bit about my vlog and about coronavirus. And now I also want to have another little bit of a chat here about people and some of their crazy beliefs. One person, I believe, already believed that one. Now, here's an issue I have. Because I'm a Christian, well, even though I'm a Christian person, I've been brought up in a Christian household and been to churches and stuff. I do apologize for people that sometimes I don't seem like Christian because basically of my swearing and sometimes my attitude and some of my jokes. I do apologize for that. But yeah, I am a Christian person, even though sometimes I don't act like one. But I still have my strong beliefs that the Bible is 100% God's word and is accurate. Now, this is where a lot of people get into a lot of hissy fits and fights about. But here's the way I see it, right? It says in the scripture, it says here, there's about 52 verses about the word of God. And here's one thing. This is referring to being, I think, also being like the sword of the Spirit. It says here in Hebrews 4, verse 12, "For the word of God is alive and active, and is sharper than any two-edged sword. It penetrates and divides the soul and the spirit, and joins the marrow, and it judges the thoughts and attitudes of the heart." Now the concept is more or less, first of all, I want to change up because that was the New Living Translation, I believe. But if I go into another version, it still means the same thing. So I just changed it up, and yeah, and here it is. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly and equipped for every good work. That's in 2 Timothy 3 verse 16 and 17. And so basically we go to the point that the word of God we're talking about, or scripture, is basically inspiration of God. So all the stories and everything that's been written, kept, left out, whatever you want to put it, is actually inspired by God himself. And basically these people who wrote the Bible were inspired by God to write the Bible. And so when people say, the Bible isn't all true, half of it's all just stories and fiction, you can't take it seriously, I'm sorry, but if some of you Christian people say that, you're not a true Christian. I'm sorry, but you're not, because a true Christian believes the word of God. And if God is just and wholesome and true, and God is basically God will never lie or deceive or say anything again that goes against his principles, then okay, if half the Bible is lie and God says, you know, you should not lie, and goes down that path of, you know, that Satan is a deceiver and a liar and he hates that kind of stuff that Satan does, then if God himself lies, then how's that work? That means God is contradictory. Which God isn't. God is just, God is pure, God is, you know, God is God, you know, he's everything. Everything good, that is. But I was trying to think of, I was looking for a particular one. Just wait a minute. Okay, the The one other thing I was looking for was in John 1:1, which I believe states, and that the Word of God was with God. I'm just trying to actually find that scripture and pull it up. Okay, well, I'm not exactly sure what's there, but wait a minute. I'm just trying to find it. Yeah, I can't really find it right now, but I basically was saying, you know, that the Word was with God at that point. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. So, again, it's also, I think, referring that basically, Jesus also had the Word, the Bible, already in his head, more or less. That's what I'm sort of getting the idea of. So basically, the Word was with God, and God was with the Word, and da 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 da. From John, in the beginning, the Word, and the Word was with God. There we go. And the Word was God. So, basically, that's what I'm saying. So, technically speaking, if we are going along by that line from John, 1 John, in the New Testament, or wherever, the point being is that basically, either you want to say the Word is Jesus or God, but the point being is that the Bible was already constructed by God originally. That's the reason why you have so many religions, even ones that claim to be older than the Bible, having some sort of biblical aspects in those other religions before the Bible was actually fully constructed, if you were. A lot of the stories from the Bible were passed down generation to generation to generation, mainly from the Hebrew and the Jewish side, as well as also some other variant religions as well. Like, there's some parts of those things that stayed, such as like the Noah's Ark story, Abraham and Isaac and Jacob story. There's been many stories from the Bible, well, what we call the Bible, or the Torah in other cultures and stuff, from the Jewish perspective. But the point being is that the Word, the Bible, is considered to be God's Word. That's the reason why I really don't like other different translations other than the King James Version and the New King James Version. The reason why I don't like other Bibles myself is because they start taking liberty and start taking some of the scriptures, adding or taking away parts of scripture, which is not, and it says the Bible should never be tampered with like that. So, and that's the problem with some people who actually get those Bibles. They say, hang on, wait a minute, this says this here, and then it's completely contradicting, says something else here. Nah, that can't be real. And people throw their Bibles away when really they should just get a better Bible, not throw away a Bible, but go actually get a decent Bible that actually does know what it's talking about. And the King James and the New King James versions do know what they're talking about. Okay, they may have thus theyeth saith the Lordeth kind of Elmer Fuddeth talking, but overall they know what they're talking about. So, as far as we said, the King James and New King James is the closest English version of the Bible you'll get, or there's also another possibility of actually getting the original Bible. We'll see if you can find a direct translation from Hebrew to English. That would be an awesome Bible to have. I'd say probably be even more accurate as opposed to the later ones, which were Latin, Greek, Latin and Greek, which were what was translated into the English version. So, yeah, but I'd say probably try and get most of those ones, you know, the Latin, Greek, and Hebrew direct translations into English would probably be the best Bibles you could get. And then maybe even correlate between all three of those and see what you get. But overall, I consider the Word of God to be real. Now, for some people would say, oh yes, but there are parables in the story. Jesus told parables in the story, and they weren't real stories. They were just stories that Jesus made up to try and tell a parable to teach people with. Okay. Granted. However, we do not know if those stories that Jesus actually told were based on genuine events or not. See, that's the thing. When Jesus was telling those parables and those stories were to relate to the people about what he was trying to talk about. You know, when Jesus tried to talk to the disciples and stuff about, you know, heaven and stuff, they just went over their heads. Even when Jesus told them about, you know, trying to symbol out how he was going to die and about his death, they're like, no, Jesus, you're not going to die, you're going to be fine. They couldn't comprehend what was going to happen. So the reason why Jesus told stories and parables is so people could understand, you know, in a roundabout way, what he was trying to get at in many things. Now, if you were to say, oh yes, but all the Old Testament, they were just parables, they didn't happen, like the flood and all that stuff. Here's the thing, the flood did happen, and that's how we know that happened is because of the fossil record. Now, people say, no, the fossil record doesn't show the flood ever happened. It can't, it doesn't. Well, I can tell you, it does. How does that work? The fossil record shows that the flood did take place because every fossil, go Google it, go look it up, every single fossil has been found submerged in water. And to me, that just proves that the flood actually happened. Most of all that stuff with all the dinosaurs and everything getting covered up and plowed down in plaster and mud and all this stuff, you know, it had to be the flood that did it. And also another thing I'd like to point out, the reason why I say it didn't take millions of years or billions of years for fossils to develop, is because a lot of these things that were basically taken and fossilized were things that happened very quickly and instantaneously. It was like, well, like an ichthyosaur, which is basically like a dolphin-looking marine reptile. Basically, the ichthyosaurus was captured live giving birth. Now, if that whole body, both the baby, the dead baby, and the mother all died all at once and just sunk to the bottom of the ocean and just, you know, everything just rotted away and then all covered up with dirt after that, that doesn't make any sense because a lot of predators and stuff, a lot of the bones would be missing. These skeletons are complete. Complete. Therefore, it goes to the point that the fossilization happened rapidly. Underwater conditions. Therefore, the flood did actually happen as the Bible had said. Now, due to the fossil record. Now, all the other stories in the Old Testament, yeah, it did happen. Because you can see they also did segments of genealogies. They said son of, daughter of, son of, daughter of, son of, daughter of. And you even see that in the New Testament. They say son of, daughter of, son of, daughter of, daughter of, son of. And they give you a lineage of, which I got bored with a lot of the time when I was reading that out in the Bible, in Bible stuff. But, yeah, they show a lineage of progression of those people. I mean, of course, you could say if a story was made up or a story was just a parable or just a story, that the stuff that could be fake, yeah, that could be true too, but in so much detail, if it was just a story, there would be no point in making it so intricately woven and intricately detailed. If it was just a story, it would only just be about that one person, and that's it. There's a lot of other things that connect into that story. A lot more things are more realistic, per se, as opposed to not being. And a lot of people say, okay, well, what about the miracles that Jesus performed, turning water into wine? That can't happen. Yeah, it can, by rearranging the molecular structure and molecules. It's a science. Also, if you want to go into like a spiritual possibility, we have, cordials and, juices and powders that we sprinkle in water that actually make the water taste like it does. So there's even possibility that maybe an angel or a spirit can come down under the command of God to actually sprinkle that stuff to make that happen, or lift someone up off the ground. Just because we can't see a spiritual being doesn't mean that it's not there, and doesn't mean that the person's doing that power all on their own accord. So you want to say, the possibility, Jesus walking on water, he was just walking on a sandbank. Yeah, okay, if that was possible, he's just walking on a sandbank, this was during a storm, which means there'd be sinkholes, and there'd be a lot of different things going on if Jesus was just walking on a sandbank when he was walking on the water. There's a lot of things that doesn't really make sense if you don't consider the possibility of a spiritual realm, or don't consider there is a science that we do not know about. And that's a big problem, because there's probably an unknown science that we don't know about, and that's the stuff that goes into like a spiritual-esque world, such as your angels, your demons, your gods, your gods, Satan, and all that. But like I said, it's just all that sort of thing, people, that, just checking thing. So that's what I'm sort of saying, people. I believe that the Bible is 100% real and accurate, and even some of the stories and parables that were supposed to only just be stories and parables, I believe could have actually happened, because if they did not happen at some point to someone, then those stories would not relate to people, if they weren't somewhat based on reality. So there you go, people. That's my take on it. I believe the Bible is 100% real, and I really don't think some of you people that claim you're Christians out there who say the Bible is, it's 90% real and 50% just stories and stuff. The stuff that's not real. If that was the case, that half the Bible is truth and half the Bible isn't real, then basically your mind is, your decision and your whole thought processing is divided, because basically you're saying that half the Bible is a lie and half the Bible is truth. But if the Bible is God's word and God hates lying, that doesn't make any sense. So therefore, I do declare that if any one of you people believe that the Bible isn't God's word, or if you people believe the Bible is only half truth, then I'm sorry, but you're not a Christian in my eyes. I'm sorry, that's the way I see it. Even the Bible says in the end times, in Revelation, it says people will come to God saying, Lord, Lord, I've done miracles, I've done things in your sight, I've cast out demons, I've done this and done that. And Jesus, and God says, and probably Jesus too, and maybe God, just God himself says, just depart from me, for I never even knew you. And they get sent to hell. So, I'm sorry, people, but unless you guys accept that the Bible is actually the true word of God, I'm sorry, but you're not Christian. I'm sorry. There's a couple of things that make people a Christian. One, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, you shall be saved. So, first, salvation comes from Jesus. Then you also have the thing of believing and belief, but then that can be divided up. But I really don't think, if you think that the Bible and a lot of things that are fake in it, you're not a Christian. I'm sorry. If some of you people claim to be Christian and believe the Bible is half fake, I'm sorry, you're not a Christian in my eyes. But here's the thing: if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, you shall be saved. And that's the most important thing. Salvation comes through Jesus and Jesus alone. which I know is going to piss a lot of people off too, but that's the way I see it. Sorry for my swearing, but that's the way I see it. This is going to tick a lot of people off, but the way I see it is there's only one man who, or one being, that can point to salvation, that is Jesus Christ. There's never been any other person on this planet who can claim that they've actually died, well, claimed to have been resurrected and died and resurrected, or claimed that they were actually killed and were brought back. See, here's the thing. A lot of people can claim, oh, yes, I was resurrected, but they could have just had a real big, deep sleep, and then someone couldn't wake them, and then eventually think. I think there's even a condition where people actually, you know, have that thing when they fall asleep, and some people thought they were dead, and they wake up. So, you know, there is a thing there, but someone who actually, like Jesus, got nailed to a cross, who got killed, literally killed, got nailed to a cross, spear in his side, everything, and had a big stone rolled over his grave, and yet somehow, amazingly enough, the stone was rolled away, and he was no longer in the grave, resurrected. Now, people could say, oh yeah, that was the disciples who did that. Really? Really? Where would they hide a dead body, for starters? Second of all, how many people after that time, when Jesus was supposed to have resurrected, did they see him? There's been multiple accounts. Even the Bible says that there were multiple accounts Jesus actually came back, but they can't actually fit it all, write it all in. I have to look that up. But, yeah, there's been, Jesus did come back, and Jesus was resurrected. So, I don't see, no offense, but I don't see Buddha getting resurrected. I don't see, you know, some of the Shinto or some of the other religions around where they have had their main religious leader come back from being dead. I'm sorry, I haven't seen that. But yeah, just wrapping up, people. The way I see it is the Bible is the word of God and it is the truth. The whole Bible is the truth. And if you want to call me crazy before that, go ahead. But as far as I'm concerned, people, the Bible is the truth. Okay, catch us all later, people. Bye.